On the telephone line with us is the Pirates general manager, Neil Huntington, who made the deal today. Mark Melancon goes to the Washington Nationals. The Pirates get a couple of hard-throwing lefties, including big league setup man Felipe Rivero, and then they also picked up minor leaguer Taylor Hearn. Neil, you talked to members of the media earlier today, but for anyone who didn't get a chance to hear, how tough was it to do this? Was it a foregone conclusion that at this stage where the Pirates are in the standings, National League Central Division standings, and with the fact that there's no way the Pirates are going to re-sign Melancon at the end of this year, that you really had to move him between now and Monday?
Well, first of all, no, it was not a foregone conclusion. We looked at a choice between good options. Good option one was to keep Mark Melancon, keep the stability, keep the known in the back end of that bullpen, take a run as far as we can this season, and hopefully it gets us into the postseason, and then move from there and go our separate ways at that point, but look to have two quality months out of Mark Melancon. Option two is the option that we took, and it was a very difficult one. Mark is an unbelievable person. He's made such an impact on this community, on this club, and that goes well beyond what he did for us on the field. He's a great family man. He has a terrific family, and he's been a part of us, and these moves are extremely difficult. At the same time, in December of 2012, as I told the media earlier today, we traded an all-star closer for an unproven reliever that we felt could do some quality things, and our goal is to keep that chain moving forward, and we have five-plus potential seasons of contribution from Felipe Rivero. We have Taylor Hearn, who is another big, strong, athletic, loose-armed left-hander that we add to our system and gives us another starter option somewhere down the road, or, you know, the bullpen, given the power that he has, in the velocity that he has, power arm that he has. He could fill a bullpen role, but our goal is to have him start. But no, this was extremely difficult. It doesn't change our goals for this year. It's our belief in Tony Watson, our belief in Neftali Feliz, that they can step in and handle the ninth and the eighth, and Felipe Rivero can step in and handle that mid to high leverage role for Clint, and we can keep this thing pushing forward. And we deal from our strength. We deal from the strength of a very good player that was going to be here for two more months, and we add a couple of left-handers that could impact us for years to come.
Well, now your magic is already working. We get the leadoff single to get the ball yeah. rolling here. you know, obviously, I think, you know, I love what you did. You did what you had to do. I think everything I've read on the internet, everybody around baseball, you know, talking about how this is a, you know, really one of those trades is good for both clubs. And it also, and this has to make you feel good after what you just said about Mark Melancon, which everything, you know, agree, you know, what a, you know, great guy and everything that he's done for the team. But you traded him to a place to where he's got a chance this year to maybe go a long ways. They have a very good club over there in Washington. We got a little taste of that. But it has to make you feel good when you move somebody on to a good situation. You're not sending him off to the hinterlands.
Well, and we fully expect it to be one of those teams that battles with the Nationals, and we look forward to playing against Mark Melancon and using the knowledge that we have of how Mark pitches and how he competes to our hitters' advantages. But you're absolutely right. Washington is a great situation for Mark. We were a good situation for Mark, and our goal is to be right there with Washington if they're fortunate enough to get in, and our goal is to battle and to still be in this thing and to be one of the final five teams in the National League standing. We do still like the quality of this club, and our goal hasn't shifted one bit after this trade.
See Josh Harrison getting the leadoff hit and Jordy Mercer at the plate. No one count, with Jameson Taillon on deck talking to the Pirates general manager about the trade and how difficult it was. And Neil, you know, during the offseason, many thought that Melancon was going to be dealt. Did there come to a point where that kind of got close for you and you just put something on the back burner if an opportunity arose at this point this season and you kind of revisited something, or did this just crop up in the past few days?
We had a number of conversations with a number of clubs in the offseason. We did not find that we thought to be the right scenario, the right return. And so we held Mark. And again, as we said at the top of the interview, we would have held Mark had we not found what we believed to be the right return. And we believe this was the scenario in which the return was right. And again, we continue to push forward with this, and Felipe Rivero comes in and adds to a quality bullpen, and we'll continue to look before Monday's deadline to see if there's something else that we can add. It is an interesting and challenging market right now, but this was the right situation, and that's where we didn't find it in the offseason. We found it today.
Is there any concern at all about the mindset of the team that when a deal like this happens, that maybe some players think, oh, there's the white flag?
Well, Clint does a tremendous job of communicating with our guys and communicating that expectations are to continue to push forward and are to continue to be a team that's on the outside looking in, but we find a way to battle back into this, and we find a way to go from the outside looking in to being on the inside looking out, which is where we were a year ago. In terms of the player mindset, we completely understand that they lost a good friend. We completely understand that they lost a guy that we've been so dependent on in most of the ninth innings for the last handful of years. But we also believe that they look at Tony Watson as a guy that's more than capable. They look at Neftali Feliz and what he's been able to do for us for these 4 months. And they just got a chance to face Rivero in Washington when he threw those three shutout innings against us and showed the incredible velocity and the really quality changeup. And they now hopefully recognize that he's here to help us and can, and we believe will help us not only for the next 2 months, but ideally for the next 5 years beyond this year.
Neil, the bullpen has been a real strength over the last month or so, really doing a great job. The starting rotation has been inconsistent pretty much from day one. You know, they've starting to get on a little bit of a roll, and then they'll go the other way back and forth. Are you still looking out there to try and maybe get somebody to bolster that starting rotation? Is that on your shopping list these next couple of days?
Yeah, it is, Bob. The challenge is it's probably on nine of the other 10 teams that are competing with us, or maybe 15 of the 16 teams that are still in this thing. Most everyone needs starting pitching. It's the hardest thing to come by. It's the most valuable, and why we continue to emphasize with our group how crucial it is for us to develop our own starting pitching. Gerrit Cole, what a great, promising outing, his last outing. Liriano, two of the last three, really good. Jameson Taillon, the two-run home run in the first inning tonight, notwithstanding, has been really strong in his sequence of outings. And then we're in a little bit of a tough stretch with all the off days that we're bouncing guys in and out of the rotation. And so it's a little bit tough for them to stay on routine. But we do feel that between Jeff Locke and Ryan Vogelsong or Steve Brault, who pitched last night, or Chad Kuhl as he gets healthy, or Tyler Glass now down the road, or maybe even a John Neese at some point, that we can fill the other spots in the rotation if we do get shut out on the trade market, because the acquisition cost just stays above where we feel comfortable going. We do feel we can fill those other spots in the rotation. We get Francisco Liriano pitching the way he's capable of. Jameson Taillon continues to move forward, and we plug those back too with some guys that step up. We're in a pretty good spot.
Talking to the Pirates general manager Neil Huntington, the Pirates got a leadoff hit from Josh Harrison. Jordy Mercer, that flare to right, caught by Neuenheis, and Taillon not able to get a bunt down and takes a called third strike. David Freese back to the top of the Pirates batting order with the Bucks down two to the Milwaukee Brewers here in the third inning. We said we hope that this inning continues to chat with the Pirates GM. We'll be on the radio side with him tomorrow at 1 o'clock Eastern time in his weekly radio show. A lot to discuss as that trade deadline Monday approaches at 4 o'clock. And Neil, members of the media asked you today about picking up Rivero, and you talked about the great stuff that he has. Do you see when you make a deal like this, not only a guy who can slip into that seventh inning role for now, but down the road, because of all the years of control, is he a closer?
Well, as I said to the media earlier today, a closer label is earned, and there's a lot of closers in the big leagues that most people didn't think were going to be closers, and there's some guys in the minor leagues that people thought could be closers. It is different in the ninth inning. Now, you look at Rivero. Does he have the weapons to strike hitters out? Yes. Does he have the strike-throwing ability? Does he have multiple pitches? The things that closers typically he does have all of those things. How will he mature? How will he progress? How will he earn that role? That is time to tell, but we do feel he can step right into a high-leverage role in our bullpen right now.
Neil, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks, guys.
The Neil Huntington Show will be tomorrow on the radio side, and a lot of Pirate fans on hand, and that gentleman, Trust Neil Huntington 16.